right there. I want to ask you about your ties. How many do you have at this point?
I have like a big Ziploc bag in my suitcase that's full of probably like 30.
How many skateboards do you have?
I have so many skateboards, it's not even funny. I have like skateboard shelves in my house.
Have you really?
Yeah.
If you had to describe yourself as a drink, would you be a milkshake, smooth and cool, or a fizzy drink, sweet and bubbly?
A fizzy drink.
It's a weird question, isn't it?
Yeah.
Can you believe this is my job? I get to ride around in go-karts and wear wigs.
We're speeding.
How does it feel to be different from me? Are we the same? How does it feel to be different from me? Are we the same? How does it feel?
So I actually am shy.
But I'm a very shy person.
I am
shy.
Not shy, and I'm not gonna let shy. Not shy, and I'm not gonna let. It's too risky to let, you know. This is my life. I don't want to like mess up my career, and so I need to speak up and like tell people what I think. I taught myself how to play guitar when I was 12.
I started actually teaching myself guitar when I was 12 years old.
When did you start playing the guitar?
When I was 12. There was a guitar around the house that my dad had, and I picked it up and taught myself how to play.
Marina?
Yeah, I'm there.
Hey, how are you? This is Avril.
Hi, Avril.
Hi.
What's your question, Marina?
When did you first start to play the guitar?
When I was 10, something like that. I don't know.
They gave Avril her first solo.
Oh, Jesus, bless, Redeemer.
It was almost like she was in rapture.
Everybody was just amazed. And she was only 10 years old.
It was a lot of work. I've been singing ever since I was performing hardcore, ever since I was like 10.
I sang my first solo when I was 10 years old.
Where was that at?
That was at church. I started singing when I was really young, like 7, 8, 9, 10, something like that. And
I did both. I played hockey and sang, but I got my start like in church. That's
in
where,
church?
Yeah, I sang my first solo in church.
So are you like a Christian or?
I'm not like a hardcore religious person, but
you don't seem like
I come from, you know, Christian background, was brought up, raised in a Christian home and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Hey, would you say there's a new sound to let go?
Thank you. Somewhat. I have piano on this new record, and there wasn't piano before on the first record, and I think it's a little darker. So I mean, it still has some elements of the first record, but I like it better, kind of.
No, there wasn't pressure because I said to everybody, like the label and management, I asked them to not, you know, call me and ask me how it's going, and to basically not get involved until I asked them to, because. With the last record, it was kind of like we'd write a song, record it, and then FedEx it off to the label right away, and that got, you know, I didn't want to do that because I felt like then I'd feel pressure, like everyone was judging the songs right away. So I just waited till I had a whole bunch and I was comfortable with them, and then I gave it to them to listen. So that was kind of an easy way to deal with it for me. You know, I just didn't want people on the phone going, how's it going, what's it sound like? And freaking me out.
My memories from the Olympics would be just when I was younger, watching them with my family, and it was always, you know, fun checking out all the sports and time where we all got together. And I liked hockey a lot, so I really liked watching that sport.
I've just spent 17 days working with Chad Kruger and David Hodges, and the three of us have been writing a lot of songs together.
With this record, I worked with all new people, so different co-writers, Chad being one of them, and David Hodges, Jay Cash, Martin Johnson. Chad and I got together to work and to write, and then we became really good friends, and then eventually later on it turned into something else, which was really cool.
It's my name, but I have the band vibe, and I want people, when they hear my name or think Avril Lavigne, to think of me and the guys. Yeah. That's how much I want them to be involved in this, and I'm making it as much of a band as it can be. They're not just like hired musicians standing there behind me just playing, you know? It's like we have something really special.
Every day. Well, I couldn't tell you why she felt that way. She felt it every day. Where she belongs, she wants to go home, but nobody's home. That's where she lies, broken inside. Where she belongs,
crushing you from the top.
Bombshell, can't you tell now?
Watch me, watch me, watch me prove your mom.
Stand up, everybody, get up, say it loud.
With bombshells, can't you tell now?
Watch me, watch me, watch me prove you wrong.
Just watch me, watch me, watch me prove you're strong, chick. Bring it on, chick, they sing along. If you had enough of this, when it's fucked up, don't ever shut up. You gotta stand up, you gotta fight. You're strong, chick, you bring it on, chick. Just sing along if you had enough of this. When it gets fucked up, don't ever shut up. You gotta stand up, you gotta fight.
It
It's pretty cool because through technology, using internet and file sharing, someone, say, in LA can get in touch with someone on the other side of the world.
Okay, do it again. Give me your best riff.
Give me your best riff.
Ooh. Hey, Zane, I hear you're playing Japan.
I am playing Japan. It's funny you should ask, and it's so weird that I have to meet Cameron here while you're asking me. I am playing Japan, and I'm very excited about playing riffs like that and singing my own songs.
What cities are you going to?
I'm playing three.
So we have a new photo for this for an 8x10 exclusively. That's funny. Hi. So I'm going to sign a ton of these 8x10s. Do you guys like my hair better, straight or fluffy? No extensions, bitches. So I'm going to sign a bunch of these.
Hey, everybody. Thank you once again for supporting the Avril Lavigne Foundation's annual birthday party with Limelight. Best of luck with your draw.
Yeah, it's a good place to party. And I'm of age. Woo!
How old are you now?
15.
You're cute.
Thanks.
You know you're cute.
No.
Yes, you are, Avril Lavigne.
Thanks.